What you see on screen is the very first application that I ever built, and it was completely built using AI. And the interesting thing is that to build this, especially until recently, I used only the chat interface of Claude for writing the codes. I did not use Cursor or any other IDEs for this application until recently. If you have followed me from the start, you would have probably already seen this application in use, but I've added some additional features to this. And to be frank, this project kind of went to the back burner for a while. I think I did not do anything with this app for 2 months. First of all, I focused on growing this channel. And other than that, I was also building other applications, which allowed me to actually come back to this and then take it to Cursor and build it in a more organized manner. Let me quickly show you what I've added and then explain how and why each of these things were done. So right from start, what happened was I had missed a feature right in the starting, and then I found it extremely hard to add that feature. And that was this simple thing, which is the rotation. So the shapes could be moved and scaled earlier, but I couldn't rotate it. So I added the rotation feature, which was actually complicated because it had to be added at the base level. And I hadn't added that initially. And the second feature is something that I'm very, very excited and very proud of. And that is the color picker pop-up is now like this. Okay, this might not seem like a lot, but I'll explain it and I'll come back to this one. Other than that, there was a fundamental problem. And that is, well, basically, that the code base was really large and adding any new feature became really, really hard. So I needed to have a modularized version of my code. So I'll show you how my code looked, okay? So this is what it was. So I had all these versions. So this is 172 version or whatever. So if I just open that file, this is not even HTML. This is a TXT file. And this is how my code was. This is 7,500 lines of code. And anyone will tell you that that is a very bad way of working with codes to have such a long vertical file. So it needed to be modularized. But the problem was that it was already too large, and modularizing it also was very, very complicated. So what I did was, first of all, I separated the CSS. So I separated this section till here, the CSS. Another file was created for the HTML, and the rest was all the JS or JavaScript files. So three files were created. What I did was I went to Claude, and in Claude, so let's say this is the exact chat I had. So I gave the CSS files here and I said, can you help me modularize this CSS file in a meaningful way without skipping a single line of code? In case there are any skips, please indicate in the code. So I gave that CSS file and it started working on it. This was fairly easy. This CSS section modularization was fairly easy. And it did it, the whole thing, it did it in one go itself. And in the end, just to make sure that nothing else was skipped, I asked it to compare. So I copied each and every single file. So I copied all these files, put it into a single file, and then pasted it here again, and then asked it to compare it to the original file that I gave it. So it came back saying there is nothing missing. So I was confident to go ahead. But the complicated part was this one, the JS, okay? Because the JavaScript itself was 6,500 lines of code. And the first time I did, I tried to do the same thing. So I gave the JS code and said, I just copied the same exact prompt here. So this is what happened. So it gave the file structure, and then some of those things were done. And if I just go a little bit down, this is it. That's all. It's not 6,500 lines of code for sure, right? So it is a very diluted version of my code, and that was not going to work. So what I did was I used the same thing. So I said, I know it's a large file. Can you try to do the whole thing, or at the very least, without skipping any functions, can you at least list out all the functions or main line in each file so that I can manually copy the real code, but the listing should be accurate. So this whole process of manually copying and pasting the code took almost half a day, but totally worth it. So it gave me all these files. The initial files were fine, but then you can see here, it says the function constructor execute undo. So all of these things, it listed the functions that I needed to put in each file. And this is where CodeView would actually help me. So let's say, for example, I'm just going to copy this whole code. I'll go to CodeView it, and I'm actually going to paste it here. And if I come to Claude, here, let's say we are looking at this particular file. And let's try to get this one. Update, undo, redo buttons. Okay, I'm just going to copy that. I'll go to CodeView it. And here, I'll just paste it. And I have these things. All of these things came in. But I want the function. So I'm just going to do one thing. I'll just say function. Okay. And I only have one here. If I just press enter here, I have the function. So I can just literally copy this from here and paste it into another file. So this process was very easy because I had this tool with me. This might seem really tedious, but I finally had this modularized version of the code. If I just look at the first one, so this is what I had. So I had all the CSS, all these files. Then I had the JS file, which is what was the complicated one. In JS, I had so many different folders, all of which was recommended by Claude. Like this, these files were clearly mentioned, and in each of those files, what goes into that, it was clearly mentioned. So I had this index.html file. If I double click on that, it opens and it was working fine. So I realized that it was working. So I went into Cursor, then I started adding new features. So that's how this whole modularization process was done, even though my existing code was 7,500 lines of code. And this is how I modularized a very large code base. Now, someone who's a coder would not like this process, but I'm not a coder. I've never developed anything in my life. This was the very first thing that I ever tried to create. So this, I would still say, for anyone who's starting, I would still say, use the same method of creating the code in Claude. You could get really frustrated when some version doesn't work in Cursor. So initially, it is easier to just save every file every now and then, and then go back. If something goes wrong, just go back to the previous version. So that becomes, and there are many ways to do it, but I'm still learning all those things. So having said that, this process has certainly worked out for me. So if I just go back here, and the second thing that I added, like I said, was the rotation. The problem with this was that the rotation was not added at the start. And because it's a fundamental feature, adding something at the bottom, and I was not able to do that, especially with the vertical code, or maybe the AI wasn't good enough at that point in time. But this time around, once I modularized it and I tried it, and it worked out straight away. That was such a blessing, because I was under this impression that, okay, this product is not going to have the rotation feature. So I just told myself that this is how it is going to be. But it worked out great, fantastic. And the third thing, obviously, like I said, I'm very, very proud of this, and that is the color picker. And it might seem quite stupid for a lot of people, because what is there in a color picker, right? So I'll show you. This is how the color picker was. Okay, this is the earlier version of this particular software. And if I click on this color picker, this is what we get. Okay, I come from video field, I'm a designer. Okay, so for me, I've always worked with opacity, and it really bugged me. Right from start, I've been trying to do this. I couldn't do it, actually. What happened was, this was automatically added, this RGB. This is the default HTML color picker for the browser, and I was trying to style it. After like 2-3 days of trying it, only then I got to understand that you cannot style this thing. You have to do it separately. And at this point in time, if I have to use an RGBA picker, I'll probably use something like Picker, which is a third-party library. I didn't know of those things at that point in time. Then I added a lot of features. I made sure that the color picker buttons looked like this. And once I did that, changing the color picker became quite impossible at that point in time. So from this to something like this is a big leap. Okay. So what this does is actually it has these swatches I can give. So I can pick colors from these swatches if I want. I can move it in the color area and get that. You know, I have the hue selection and the opacity, which was the most important thing. But you know what? I've added something quite crazy with this one. And you probably would have noticed that here is this one. The ability to add gradients. Okay. So I don't think any premium apps also have that feature. So I have this small toggle here. I can click on it and the gradient will be applied. Okay. And I can select one of these things and change the color from there, or whatever, I can do that, right? So this feature, I mean, it was very hard to actually add this particular feature, which is the gradient. If you see here, I'll show you some issue. Like say, for example, if I just add it here and I'm gonna add, and this was the earlier version of the picker. And to be frank, I liked it better. The design aspect of this picker, you can see the difference. If I go to this one, this is the picker that we have right now, but this was the earlier version and it looked better and I loved it, to be frank. But the fact is that the height is a little too much and it created a lot of problem, especially with the gradient toggle on. It would become longer and it was not a very good experience using this. And you probably have seen this here. The gradient is not getting added to the shape. So I struggled a lot to do that. I think it took me an entire day of going back and forth with cursor to actually get this gradient applied. Okay, so that's what it is. So I just feel like you just have to be persistent and you have to have the grit to say, okay, I'm going to get it done. I'm going to keep asking, keep giving the prompts. And obviously you have to constantly keep changing stuff. You have to test the application, because if you don't test, when the AI is fixing something, it will break something else. It will happen. The fact is that I had to add the gradient twice. And why? Because once it added everything, the gradient was perfect, but it created a problem that did not exist earlier. And you can see that here in this image. I'll just show. Okay, this is what was happening. So if I scale this shape, instead of the shape scaling, only the view box was scaling with the text in the middle. And this happened only for the shapes that had the gradient. So then I had to go back, go really back, restore something, and then build it again. So these things will happen. But having said that, you can build really, really powerful applications using AI at this point in time. And I don't think there is any excuse saying that I cannot code and stuff like that. If you are interested in building stuff, if you want to do stuff, if you want to start startups, then you can do it. Just use the AI. And if you have the willingness to sit and get stuff done, it can be done. Okay. I have actually built a lot of other applications in the last 1 month. That's what I was focusing on. One was my YouTube channel and the second one was other applications that I built. If you guys are interested in watching videos on those applications as well, please let me know in the comment section and I'll create a video for you guys. That's it for this video. I just wanted to cover this whole thing. And to be frank, I'm really, really excited. If you'd like to watch more videos like this or anything related to AI, please subscribe to the channel, like this video, share it with your friends, and I'll see you in the next one.